So you've got a goal in your mind, the perfect physique sculpted through bodyweight training, a bulletproof mind of focus and discipline, masterful stewardship of resources, time, and energy, rock solid strength demonstrated by fluid movement and skill, which is the new sexy. And I'm gonna keep it PG on this channel, but you see this massive roadblock between you and your goal. The goal is in your mind, and so is self-sabotage. And everybody faces this little imp. I'm gonna show you five ways to defeat it. And stay until the end, because the last step is the ultimate key. So subscribe so you don't miss any lessons that all of our top students receive. Okay, the first is to recognize that nobody, how sparkly a person makes their life appear, is immune. So don't believe the glitz and the glam. And definitely don't compare yourself to others. You need to fight that urge, probably more than working on the actual goal itself. I had this student the other day saying that his goal was to be better than so-and-so. And what happens if that other person just up and totally changes? Are you gonna change too? So first thing is recognizing that goals stem from your own brain, and so do the roadblocks. Success or failure comes from nobody else's brain but yours, and the first step is simply to recognize that and then move on. The next step is to recognize how guilt and shame play a huge role. Ever feel bad about something? Not being perfect, not doing X, Y, or Z that you know you should be doing, training, doing your strength, your flexibility, your nutrition, and then you don't do what you should be doing. The past will hold you back more than anything else will. So you must simply move forward. It does take work. It's kind of like picking yourself up after you just fell off of a bicycle. It might even be painful, but you must move forward and do things differently than you did in the past. And recognize that it's the future that is yours, not the past. The past is a fart in the wind. Don't stay in it. And that's what's going to pull you out of your comfort zone, which leads to the third step. So now, once outside your comfort zone, you must face the frigid, cold air, the freezing hail pelting you in the face. This is how the world is designed. It isn't just pulling a slot machine lever and hoping for the best like down in Vegas. The greater the risk, plus work, plus perseverance, the greater the reward. That's why we enjoy movies so much. And that's what you need to turn your life into. Your life is a movie, but is it worth watching? What makes it worth it is the quest, the peril, the getting beat up, the getting back up, and the victory. The transformed lives in the process, including yours, and all of those you don't even see. And if you want help from me and my team with staying on the track with your training and not getting thrown off course, just let us know by clicking any of the links below. And then the fourth step to overcome self-sabotage is enjoying the quote-unquote failures just as much as the victories, and then doing it over and over and over again, because failures don't really even exist. For all they are experiences that add up to your life. I often say that my paintings are like a million failed brushstrokes, each one fixing the last. Or like the hundreds of reps you don't even realize you did in a workout session. And the rebuilding and biomechanical correction that adds up to press handstands, V-stands, or a muscle up. And I tell my business team the same thing. Just keep showing up to the plate for your at-bats. It's like Babe Ruth, who was the record holder of home runs, but also the record holder of strikeouts. And this leads to your physical training, step number five. You see, the ultimate key is this: consistent, repetitive, directed physical action overcomes self-sabotage. In fact, it's the only thing that will, from the neuroplasticity where your brain actually rewires as a result, to your physical training. But here's the catch. The research is competing on the precise numbers, but it's often stated that you need 3,000 to 5,000 repetitions to build muscle memory. And the average person swipes their phone over 2,000 times per day. So what's really being trained? Plus, it also takes 3,000 to 5,000 to correct the mistakes you've been making. So starting correctly and doing it right is essential, because when you start correctly, it only takes about 300 to 500 reps to learn something from scratch. So the ultimate key is correct, consistent action over the long term while staying on your quest with a group of people who have your back and a community rooting for you to win every day. Otherwise, it's a lonely journey marred by self-sabotage, which doesn't have to be the case. And you can definitely overcome self-sabotage and build a powerful athletic physique, manage your resources like a master, have great relationships, and even gain total body mastery. And if that's what you want, we have more videos for you. And of course, click any of the links to dive deeper with us and accelerate your training. And I'll see you there.